We're doing a little bit of a deeper dive on AAOI and I'm looking at AAOI and the run that it's made and what it could potentially do. And ultimately, I will give you my conclusion or game plan for how to trade this, or how I would trade it looking ahead here. So some of the indicators that I have, what I have drawn in this chart, I have an anchor VWAP, which from the swing low here, which is the average volume weighted average price since here. So if you average the cost, the volume and the price from here, this green line shows you on average, everyone is above in the green, and then it pulls back. Now on average, you're in the red if you just bought every week. And I think it also calculates the amount of volume that went into it. So typically the way that I understand this and reading from what I've learned from Brian Shannon and my own personal experience using this indicator, let's get this out of the way here. So it's green because it's from a swing low. I've made it green. But what I've learned is as it pulls below and then as it breaks above, you don't buy this dip. You buy strength after the dip. So you buy it as it's breaking above here. And the way that I have this chart color coded, is orange is a solid uptrend typically, and then green, orange is a screaming hot uptrend, green is still an uptrend, and then white is more or less basing, blue, so then they have a buy signal with buy signals which are blue, and the cyan is more of a bottoming type of a signal, whereas blue is like it's within an uptrend already. And then purple, which is a potential sell signal. It is a sell signal. Well, you have to see what happens after that candle. And then red is a downtrend. And you can see the way this is set up where, it's in a downtrend in red. And as it turns white, it's just saying that it's starting to slow down. That downtrend is starting to slow down. So start to get ready that you might start to see some buy signals. Now this one actually went down quite a bit more once it turned white. But here you can see you have, just kind of backtrack, getting a little off track here, but you have a higher low right there from this. Here, so it's kind of telling you that maybe we're trying to finally reverse this trend, this huge downtrend that it's had from the peak, from going from basically $100 down to $1.50. Wow. So anyway, the way that I look at it today is it's not very clear what to do, because you have this big red anchor VWAP from the all-time highs, which is on a weekly chart, has acted as resistance. And you can see that it's never closed above it. All right, so tried here, tried here, tried here. And I'm guessing that if you rewound this back, that this red line might have been down here. If we were able to go back, so it acted as resistance before. But anyway, it's got earnings coming up. That's the key thing. It has earnings coming up February 22nd. Now you could just say, okay, here's your A, B, C structure, potential setup. So if it breaks above this high, you could take it. What I would like to see is, I'd wait for earnings. Ideally, I'd like to see something like what happened with SMCI. Now, if we look at the differences between these charts, let's look at the weekly squeeze setup. This had a nice base, a nice really long sideways consolidation. And it also had a squeeze, which is what these white and red dots mean. So it was getting really tight. So building up a lot of energy to make a big run like this. When you look at AAOI, it's really been choppy, right? And there's no squeeze. It's in an uptrend, right? So it's just all at this point, I've read a lot into this. I'm reading a lot into this chart. It's not a clear crystal clear setup. It's not easy right now. So to me, I'm looking at this like, it's in a void at this time. If you look at a daily chart, and it is holding above that red line. On a daily chart, it does look a little bit better of a setup here. We just have to wait and see what happens with earnings, because if it does what SMCI does and it gives you a chance to buy, they had such great news after hours here, and it gave you a chance to buy above this high or even at the open and make a nice run. So could if AAOI were to do something like that, then you can get in close to this level. And if it gaps up like 35% or whatever, it's up here like $30, I would probably either avoid it or take a smaller position and just put my stop like somewhere below that gap up. But basically what I'm doing is preparing myself for what could happen after earnings, and I'm not going to get involved in it right now, at this juncture.